People aren't. Oh, okay. There we go. I forgot what we're doing here.
Well, you know, we've been gone a little while, so it happens.
3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah. People didn't forget about us, right?
No, because I've been getting stalked as to when we're coming back.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good.
So
people do love us.
We're back.
Oh my goodness.
People, we are back.
I have, I'm teaching a class this semester. And so they've, of course, every time I meet somebody new, I'm like, everybody has to listen to this podcast.
Yes.
And they're like, well, can we be on it? And now mind you, I do have some golfers in my class that are from like all over the place.
Oh, okay.
Canada.
Very nice.
Michigan.
Wonderful.
Overseas somewhere.
Sure.
Like France.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So shout out to them. They better be listening to this episode.
Yes. Get your and they want to come
on.
In.
And they want to come on.
Well, we'll see if they make the cut.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I had Kenlin hand out a ton of our wonderful Coaching Caffeine and Comedy stickers at a junior high volleyball game the other day.
I heard about this because I got a cute photo of you and Maddie Merritt.
Yeah. It was so fun.
Oh my goodness. How did you see the Merritts?
Just the mom.
Just the mom?
Just the mom and the daughter. She did such a good job of introducing herself to you, which is awesome. Like young people.
Yes.
Introduce yourself. Communicate.
For sure.
Talk to somebody.
For sure.
Have a conversation.
I forgot. Like I completely forgot about what you look like. I just love looking into your soul right now.
Well, you know, we're going to remind people who we are.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So welcome back to another episode of Coaching Caffeine and Comedy. I'm your host, Hayley Kobza.
And I'm Lena.
And this is really cool podcast that we started. And then life got really busy. We thought we were ahead of the game.
We did. We kind of were-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah, sort of.
And then I was like, our manager just failed to post some episodes.
Well,
and so they're clearly not getting the Christmas bonus.
Nope.
And then the time to it. Yeah. How's that going?
It's good. It's good. Yeah. Keep
that
going.
That looks horribly uncomfortable for you.
Fine. Okay. I'm fixing it. Yeah.
And then we just didn't have time to make an episode.
No.
So at least we're going to get two done today.
Yes, we are.
Yes. What?
There. It's just there.
No, I think... No, it's the sides. You need to tighten these if it's... There we go.
Okay.
There we go.
It's when you're gone this long, you forget how all the equipment works, including...
Well, I'm glad I didn't have to set any of this up. So there's
that. Well, we'll see if it works.
Yeah, because watch, we get done with like an hour and then it's like, oh, it didn't even record. But there's a red light.
B-team was on today.
Oh, yeah.
B-team as in me setting things up.
Yeah.
That's what I meant.
Oh, yeah. Because I'm the A-team.
Yeah.
Let's just start off by thanking our awesome sponsors that, you know, have been with us now for 9 months.
Yes.
And they are all doing huge things. Like, so first and foremost, Wild Ass Soap Company out of McCook, Nebraska, locally owned, locally made, super awesome stuff. Like they are just kicking butt, taking names.
Yeah.
If anybody follows them on Facebook, you need to follow them on Facebook because you need to see all what they're up to. They made this super fancy trailer. So they've been on the road. I think they were at State Fair. I had so many people sending photos of them in the booth, which was so cool. They're like, oh my gosh, this is the stuff that you talk about. I'm like, oh, yay.
That's good.
Tell them hi. Good. And then I think they went and took and got their trailer wrapped and it looks so cool.
I have not seen
it. I'll just share that on our Facebook page.
Yes.
And who else do we have?
El Puerto,
mm-hmm.
Which is delectable, wonderful food for your tum-tum.
Still delicious.
So good.
Yeah.
And wonderful drinks.
Yes.
So thank you for everyone over at El Puerto, especially Yalo, for all that you do for the community and for us.
Yeah, she's great. And then, of course, Jolt and Joe's. And they have stuff going on all the time. So they have like a new salted caramel cookie out.
Yes.
It's delightfully delicious and full of gluten.
Oh, you'll be okay.
But it's so good. And then they have all of the new, oh my gosh, I'm losing it. They're like the drip?
Not the drip?
No, the drinks and the refreshers.
Oh, yes.
Yes, the Lotus.
Refresher. Yeah.
That's delicious. The other day I went in there and Shonda was like, well, you can mix. What are your two favorite flavors? And I'm like, ooh.
Oh.
So like I mixed peach and strawberry.
Very nice.
So good.
Very good. And so I'm just still with my Americano. She just does it right. So it's like,
yeah.
Yeah.
I love it.
Leave me alone.
Yep. That's great. Mm-hmm. Volleyball season. How's it going?
We finally had our first games this week. So, you know, 5 weeks of practice, wait for a game. Then you have your two home games that you have all year back to back.
Of course.
On a Tuesday and Wednesday. So that was fun. You know, it was good because And what was good was there was improvement from, you know, the first day to the second day. Mm-hmm. And we played Hitchcock County and Maywood Hay Center. And of course, Maywood Hay Center has a ton of girls. So that's really good for us because we get everybody some playing time. And I'm always going to say, I don't know what it would take for me to change my tune, but I feel like every kid should go out for something in junior high just to get the opportunity to learn a sport that hopefully, even if you don't go on and play in high school or beyond that, like you get this skill set that then when you, you know, you can play this game forever. Mm-hmm. And so we have every girl in junior high, which is 6th, 7th, and 8th going out for volleyball, which I absolutely love because I feel it just creates this little community within the school of this group of girls that they're a team and they can support each other and they can be, and we do this thing called Positive Pals. So every week they have to put like a positive motivational thing in their Positive Pals locker, which means me love and about, that. Yeah, it's so, so fun. So me and like three other teachers are always delivering and they get, it's like the teachers get just as excited mm-hmm. because it's a secret. It's supposed to be a secret all year. Some people kind of start to find out, but it's just about being encouraging. Mm-hmm. And even though maybe you're competing with somebody for a spot or, you know, maybe somebody didn't play so well, we can always figure out a way to be positive. So every week they do that and then they give them a goodie on game day, a little treat.
I like that.
It's so fun. And they
could you start doing that for me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I would like a positive pal note.
There for you, girl.
Every week.
Okay.
And a goodie.
I can do that.
Awesome.
Okay.
That's fun. I like that. Did you come up with that?
Yeah.
I did.
My very first year, I thought that that was something that we had to do.
Which is very funny that you're talking about work and mm-hmm. like, you know, delivering these things in lockers because, mm-hmm. you know, Letty is now going to St. Pat's and Trip. Mm-hmm. Not the same building, but your school. Yeah. And I was like, do you ever see Lena? And Letty's like, she never works.
Well, a lot of people say that even when I do.
Which is so funny.
Because like, I'm taking vacation right now yeah. to do these podcasts. Uh-huh. So, yep.
Yep.
If I come to work and there's always men outside that like mm-hmm. kind of, I don't want to say escort, but like usher are out there for the kids when we walk over to church. And so they're like, oh, you're here today, huh? And they're like, your part-time schedule must be changing up. And they're always.
And Letty, she's 3 years old yep. and even knows that. Mm-hmm. So.
Oh. Well, it's pretty obvious.
That sounds like me and yeah. Bob at the sports shop. Yeah. I know that, man. He works like when he's sleeping and every yeah. single time I give him a hard time. Yeah. I don't know if he takes it like seriously
oh, yeah.
or if he's like, oh, she's going to stop.
I know. He is kind of a softy, you know? Yeah. And so I think sometimes when he's harassed at first, he's like, really? And then he's mm-hmm. like, oh, might as well feed into this. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. He sent me something because somebody went in to order like a uniform mm-hmm. and he's like, how many kids do you even have? I keep getting Kobles on these lists. And I was like, well, there's only 3.
But yeah. Anyway, but yeah. Everyone else just puts their tab on you. It's like me at the vet when I go there with a cat. I'm like, it's under the Koble.
Oh, vet yeah. bill. I have yeah. a cat that's limping right now. And I was like, sweet. Walk it off. Walk it off.
Literally.
Yes.
Or the leg needs to go. One
yes.
of the two.
Yes.
One of the two.
We have adorable kittens at our house right now.
Oh, so free to get home.
Yes.
Kittens.
They're so adorable. They're at that fun, like playful stage. Aww. They're so cute, which would be comparable like to a toddler, like that 3 and 4 year old. Like yeah. they're just cute
yeah.
until they, you know, do some of the stuff they do. But
right.
So they like to climb up the screens.
That's oh, fun.
Yeah.
That
Jake
is fun.
Loves that.
I bet. Yes. Yes.
Yeah. And when we had the storm come through last night, everyone was just terrified for the kittens. Like we'll be fine, I guess. But these kittens.
Not the cats.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Not the cats.
Yeah.
Oh man. I'm trying to think what else has been going on. It's just been delightfully.
Well, I had a really exciting thing happen at work yesterday.
Let's hear it.
I
when you were at work.
At the one, yes. one of the times I was actually at work, I ordered 16 new books for the library.
And ooh.
Yeah, if you have not heard of this site called Thrift Books.
Yeah.
Yes. You've heard of it?
Yes.
Well,
I was the one that told you about Thrift Books.
I did not know about it.
Because I have so many points on Thrift Books. Now I get free books.
What?
Yes. I've been,
when's the last time you donated a book to the St. Pat's library?
Well, I don't like to give away my books.
Never.
And I don't think the St. Pat's kids want to read the books. I read.
Probably not.
Yeah. So I mean, they're all about leadership. They're not like what you read, right. But you know, I don't think this is the book they want for AR points.
I have to like proof, like you can go in and like find, like go to these sites. It'll tell you all the details and stuff. I was like, whoa, I don't even want to read that book, mm-hmm. let alone bring it into my library.
Yeah.
But no. Okay. So you and my counterpart across the hall, she's a big thrift book buyer. And I was
That's
like,
great.
What? I spent like, I tithed
yeah.
books to the church, like to the school last year. I just bought books to donate. I was buying them all regular price. Thank you very much.
No one was there for me then. Everybody, thriftbooks.com.
Thrift books.
So every year my players read a book. And uh-huh. so I buy all my books on Thrift Books. So I only give myself $100.
Okay.
and I will buy at least 15 to 20 books off $100.
What happens to those books when your players are done? Where is this library of leadership?
But then now I like try to give them to other people.
Oh, I have not gotten one of those yet.
I will. Yeah. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a book from a friend I had like a little birthday lunch for my birthday.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And I had a friend give me a book. I haven't started yet because I was already reading this other book.
Uh-huh.
And I haven't even finished. I've been kind of slow reading lately because I think like my body's always thinking about volleyball, which all you parents, fans, and players, even when it's junior high, it grabs hold of the brain of the coach and holds on to you.
It does.
And encapsulates you for a bit. And, you know, you sleep and you breathe and you wake up thinking about it, unfortunately.
Agreed. Yeah. And if you have TikTok, it reads your mind. So the only things on TikTok now,
volleyball.
Yeah. It's just like, oh, here's a drill. Here's a play.
It's probably why you should get off social media.
I really was thinking about it.
Well, it's not a bad idea.
I know.
So my girls had a situation where they saw on somebody else's phone, like a text, like something that went out, and it wasn't bad. It actually really was. It was kind of funny. And I was like, and they were telling me about it. And I said, now, where do you think that goes? And they're like, well, like, just like when you call somebody, like it just eventually goes off your phone. Mm-hmm. I was like, that doesn't go anywhere. And they're like, what do you mean? I'm like, that's there forever. So anyone can take a screenshot and send it. And Kenlyn goes, yeah, I don't need a phone for a while. Some of the stuff I think about, just nobody needs to hear it. And I was like, yeah, exactly.
Kenlyn. Loved it. Yeah. She is. You know, we made a good connection here not that long ago. Mm-hmm. And now I feel like we're just two peas in one pod.
Oh, well.
Remember that headrest?
Oh, that is true. Yes. That is really true.
So, yeah.
How's volleyball for you?
It's great. Yeah, just chugging along.
Yeah. Where would you say you're at in your season? Like how far?
We're halfway. We are halfway. We only have like 6 weeks left.
Wow.
And that 6 weeks is going to fly by. Yeah.
It really is.
Well, and that was 6 weeks at Monday. So like coming Monday, it'll be five. So it's really fast. And then at this point, you know, there's just a lot of things as a college coach. You just think about like, are the girls putting forth in the effort or where are their priorities? Why are we losing? And when that happens, I am way too competitive. Like when we lose, it is like, it just like grabs a part of my heart and it just like holds on to it. And I think one of my biggest things I'm working on is like, try not to take that anger home. Because like sometimes I get home and then I'm just like, nobody talked to me. Cause then it's just like volleyball. I'm just like, why did we lose? Like, what do we need to do better? Like, what do I need to do better? Like if we're making this many errors, why am I not coaching better? And then I just think about it and I stew on it. And then it's pretty quick, you know, for me, then things happen and it's like losing is not everything. Like you lose, you learn. There are bigger issues in this world for me that I need to like,
100%.
You know, like we got to play today. That's a gift. We got to wake up today. That's a gift, you know? And so I just got to like chime myself back in. But sometimes it's really hard to lose when we're not trying to win.
Oh yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. So, that's kind of where we are at volleyball right now, but great group of girls, so much talent.
Awesome.
So much talent. We have like three players in the top 10 in the nation within JCAA.
Oh, awesome.
But we got a chemistry. We got to put it together. We got to play well together.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's still early, you'd say, even though it's halfway through season.
Right. If you had to put a word, like one word on your season, on your team, on what you have going on, what would that word be?
Ooh, that's a good one. Purpose.
Nice.
Like, what is a purpose? What is your purpose? Are you playing with a purpose?
Right.
Very I think good. Purpose would be a good one.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Very, very good.
Uh-huh.
Nice.
A great group, though. Great
group. Yeah, you do have a fun
They're
group.
Fun. They're fun. And, lots of people helping out this season, so that's fun.
Yeah.
So many people.
One of it's going to be our future guest.
Yes. Like, so next week, you're going to be like, oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Why is this guy sitting on the sidelines with Cobes up?
Like, recognized throughout the state as a legend.
He kind of makes me nervous at practice.
Well, that's good.
But it's good. It is what it is.
Yeah, but don't you want to, like, surround yourself with the kind of coach that's going to challenge you, not think the same way as you?
Yeah.
You know, makes
you think outside the box.
Yes,
for sure.
100%.
100%. Our Monday night practices are one of my favorites, Monday night, we practice late on Mondays. And so we have three of our volunteer assistants come in they practice with the girls and they play with the girls. And it's just like, our Monday practices are sick. They're just like so intense. And
good.
I love it.
What else are you doing? I mean,
what else am I doing?
Any home projects? Any life projects?
No, there's no time for that.
Yeah.
If anybody wants a home project, laundry at my house needs to be done.
Got it.
My in-laws are coming this weekend.
Wonderful.
So everyone really needs to come over and clean my house before they come.
Yeah. Very nice.
Living life.
Yeah.
Living life and coaching.
Yeah.
Nothing gets done until November at my house now.
Oh, that's understandable.
Yeah. So I may or may not have worn these pants now for 3 times without being washed.
You know, details. Like, no one needs to know that. Fine. They just assume it's because they're blue.
Right.
School colors. You probably have 8 pairs.
Yeah. Just exactly. Yeah.
Well, I put out Halloween towels and soap
already.
I haven't even got
my fall decor up yet.
Excuse me. 3 weeks ago.
Wow.
But my decorations haven't gone up.
Okay.
Okay. So
are you one of those that dress up at Halloween?
Well, I wear a little hat, like a witch hat. And that's it. Like, it's this little headband. Well,
that's fitting. Exactly. That's very
fitting
for you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No, I don't really. I can't. Jake's like a fuddy dud when it comes to that. And I don't think I never, but now like my dad dresses up every year. It's like, where was that when I was little?
That's great.
So I feel like, and so really big thing that was talked about in this like study I was doing about family. It said, let your kids start traditions for your family.
Oh,
our girls on the way into school the other day decided they want the haunted house, like going to a haunted house with this group that we went with last year to be one of our new family traditions. I was like, so good.
That's so fun. You can do a haunted house?
No, actually, okay, I can't.
That's good for you though.
I closed my eyes through 40%. Well, let's 60. I mean, most of it. Okay.
Yeah.
When I saw that they had snakes, live snakes and like other critters in glass things that you had to crawl through. Mm-hmm. No.
Yeah.
I was done. I honestly think if Kenlyn would have been with me, which she kind of like bowed out, she was ready to go, I would have left her to the wolves because I would have been donezo. I would have been hauling, trying to
see,
get out.
See, Kenlyn's the one child of yours that I could be like, I could see her just being like, you guys are all weak.
Well, she was the first one in line. She's like, I'm so excited. And then when we got to the line, like it was our turn and she heard all the screaming, she's like, you know, maybe I'll just wait for you guys on the other side. And so I had to go with some strangers. Little girls that their moms didn't want to go. So I went with them.
Good for you.
Oh, was
good
it?
Good for you.
They dug into my arm with their nails. Which, again, we are strangers. We've never met.
Yes.
And we went through this together because my kids left me. They didn't care.
That's great.
Yeah.
I love that tradition for you guys.
I'll
pray for you.
I know.
I can't do that.
Jake was conveniently on call and got called out. Weird.
How that works out. Yeah. Sure. He really is doing lineman stuff. Meter maid. Lineman. Yeah.
He went for pizza with some friends, whatever, but we survived and it was so fun. And so you need to come up with a new tradition for your kids. You're going to have to think of something.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be Halloween related, but next time we talk.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. Yeah. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
Go. We started watching this show on Netflix called Painkiller.
I've seen it. I'm watching Virgin River right now. I'm trying to finish that. Yeah. So
I couldn't really get back into it. I tried. I'm sure I'm going to have a moment where I just need like a girl type drama that I'm going to be like, oh yeah. And I'm in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What did I watch that you told me to watch? And it's really good.
Lincoln Lawyer.
Yes.
Right.
So good.
So good.
So good.
So good.
Everyone needs to watch that one.
And I'm finishing Suits because I think when I first watched Suits, they didn't have season 7 and 8. And so if I'm like folding laundry, it's one of those that you can just kind of have on. So good.
See, and I need to watch Suits, but Clay is watching Suits, so I can't watch it, and then it'll mess up his timeline.
Yeah. So I'm just binge and catch up, but
And I really only have time to watch TV when I get ready in the morning. That's it. It's the only time I can watch TV right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have not had our TV on, and our girls have not watched TV during the week, besides if it's been Husker volleyball, just because like, we've been putting McCook volleyball on through the phone on TV.
Yes.
We haven't really watched any TV. It's just busy, like with tests and school and practice and whatever.
This is the season.
It is the season.
The season.
I will take a snow week this winter. Sorry, people, for all you snow haters, but I'll take some snow days.
Speaking of seasons, so I've been listening to a new podcast.
Yes.
So first and foremost, what day was it? Sunday. I was traveling.
Okay.
And so like I wasn't able to go to church. So I listened to our church service.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was just like, I want to listen to a podcast. It's like Christian based.
Right.
So then I just... you know, type in Christian podcast on Apple and one comes on, I click in. I was like,
been there.
This is probably what people hear when they hear us.
No,
and like,
no.
And so the other one was Sadie Robertson Huff.
Oh.
And I was like, you know, this girl, she's super cute. Remember we're on Dancing with the Stars. So I started listening to some of those. So good.
I'm looking it up right
now. So good. I think I've listened to like 9 episodes since last Sunday. And so one of her episodes, she was talking about seasons. And I think you are the one that's like made me start to use that word. You're like, yeah, this is the season that you're in and whatever.
Right.
And like they were talking about seasons and it was the coolest thing ever. She was like, you know, the coolest things about seasons are 3 things. 1, they have a start and they have an end.
Mm-hmm.
2,
yes,
you become a different person in every season.
Very nice.
And then 3, you grow in every season. So every season you become a different person, and which is so beautiful because sometimes you're like, you know, like these people are in my season right now.
Right.
Yeah. And it's just like, there's a start and there's an end. And then the next season comes and it's kind of a really interesting there, but her podcasts are so good. If you're looking on a Christian based, she is younger. And it, like, I think it's said on there, like the average listeners are like 18 to 20, but her mom does some podcasts too with it. And they're so good. And you like, just look at the topics and those are the ones I'm like, oh, this sounds good.
I might just have like the girls listen to some.
Yeah. And she's 28. Like, she's a mom of 2.
Aww.
Her daughter's names are Honey and Haven.
Oh,
I think it's Haven's the second one. Uh-huh. And like Honey, I'm like, that's the cutest name. And, but she just has like, she's got some really cool stuff.
She does seem like such a sweetheart. She on the, we do the Bible app every day. Mm-hmm. The girls do their version. I do mine. And she's been like, I don't know if you'd say like a visiting guest, but she'll be the one like that reads the verse of the day or she'll come on and say, and she's just like a,
It's just so good.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Right. It's exactly. So good. Right.
And yeah, definitely something I think for younger listeners talking about anxiety and just, oh, it's so good. So that was a good podcast I've been listening to. And then, what other podcast?
Well, I'll jump in and say, I listened to your Scamanda.
So good.
Yeah. Like the, I'll be honest. The first two, I was like, what is this? I could not connect. And then all of a sudden I was hooked.
Yeah.
It was, I was just like,
Mm-hmm.
Like that happens in the world.
Yes. Like what kind of sick and twisted people, and the fact that she was using a church and there was just so much disgusting in there.
Whoa. And I'm like, doodle do.
What? Yeah. Exactly.
Seriously.
Exactly. Like what in the world?
And she had so many people.
Yeah. Like hooked on it.
Yes. Like what in the world? Oh my gosh. Yes. Your nails are adorable.
Thank
Super
you.
Cute. Mine looked good until I had paint in like his room, and that's 2 weeks
on
it.
Okay, and I had another one that I started listening to. Ooh, Hooked on Freddy.
What?
And so this was one I was listening to another app, and it came on. It was like, oh, because Dr. Death said it had another episode. So I was listening to it, and it wasn't. It was just like a 5-minute blur.
I can't see when they
but
do that.
They did this like, oh, like listening on this new, and because it's by Wondery, and it's called Hooked on Freddy.
Okay.
It's so sick and twisted and wrong, but I was like, now I got to listen to it because it's about this dolphin. And,
oh, God, I see it.
Oh, my goodness. Gosh, it's just, I don't know. I can't stop listening to
really?
It. And now, mind you, it's their whole season's not out. So, like, I listened to 3 of them. I was like, where's the next episode? And it doesn't come out until Tuesday.
Oh, okay.
So, but.
Oh, speaking of Tuesdays, just like for all you who've been looking for our podcast.
Exactly. Ours comes on every Tuesday at 5 a.m.
In September, I guess. We had a little rough.
A little bit of August.
Rough patch there.
Yeah. Okay, let's play a game.
Let's do.
Okay,
are you ready?
Oh, you're going to be the first one? Are you going to explain how we're going to do this?
Ahead. No, you can be the first
one. Okay, so what we're going to do.
Yep.
We just came up with this. So we're going to give each other like really awkward situations.
Yep.
And who would we call in that situation?
Yes.
And we're going to like play it out.
Yeah.
Hopefully they answer.
Yep.
They don't know we're calling.
Yep.
And
this is going to be good.
This will be interesting.
Hope that they answer the phone.
All right.
Okay, I'm going to give you your first one.
Okay.
Okay. Ready? Clay is out of town.
Oh, God.
Okay. And you have found a den of rattlesnakes. Like, there's a ton of them.
Okay.
And they are very close to the house.
Okay.
Who do you call?
Okay. Do you want me to call them?
Sure.
Den of rattlesnakes.
Den of rattlesnakes. You have to tell them that's what's going on.
Okay.
Okay. Which this is good rattlesnake time. I'm just going to let the listeners know. This is when I have had
it's
the
cold
most...
outside.
Well, it is today. Okay. But...
Oh my gosh. Oh, there's still music going on. Hey. Hey. Okay, you don't talk.
I won't.
What if he doesn't answer? Oh my gosh.
That's going to be embarrassing.
It's going to be really embarrassing. Is there still music going on? Do you hear music?
Yes, this is Cole Schaefer. Sorry, I missed your phone call. If you would, please leave me your name and number.
And I feel like he sent you a voicemail.
I feel like he literally just sent me. Let's try it one more time.
Okay.
Yes, this is Cole Schaefer.
Oh, yeah.
Twice.
You're getting bit.
Twice.
You're
definitely getting bit. Yeah. All right. So that's strike one for me.
Okay.
All right. That was Cole Schaefer.
Yeah.
That was my brother who did not answer.
That's awkward. If anyone is driving by Cole right now and they see that.
Oh, it's your turn. We're going to go every other. So I got to use your phone.
Yeah, I know. Okay. Yeah. That's what we meant to
do. Oh, my situation.
Yeah. Oh, we're using the same situation.
Okay, no, I don't know what I'm going to do. Yeah, are these mine?
Yeah.
Is this your phone? I'm reading these.
Yeah.
Where are mine?
Right below it.
Oh, those are mine?
Yeah. I mean, you should recognize them. You came up with them, but it's okay.
These are mine? These are a long time ago. Yeah. Okay. You were at a concert and then a huge outburst occurred where a group of people came in and started protesting against the music that was being played.
Got it.
They started arresting people left and right. And of course, you're really fast, but you weren't that fast.
Okay.
And they got you.
Yeah, I got arrested.
And they said they're going to hold you in jail for 10 days.
10 days.
Unless somebody came and got you and they didn't have to pay anything. And you only get one phone call. Who do you call?
Got it.
If nobody answers yours, I'm going to feel really bad.
I got it really.
You would not be mine. I'll say that right now. Because I think I tried calling you for like 9 days once.
Oh, yeah. I am not the person. All right. We're going to give it a go.
Okay.
I'll be quiet over here. Do I need it on speaker?
Nope. Nope. There we go.
Hello.
I have a situation. Are you busy?
No, what's up?
I got arrested.
Shut up.
No. And Jake is not answering his phone.
Okay.
Is there any way you can come get me?
Yes. Where are you at?
McCook? Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah.
You're I'll also, be right there. You are live on our podcast.
You
Thank God you answered because these situations are like random. And so I was like, oh God, please answer the phone.
All right. Well, love you, girl. I'm going to let you go now.
Okay. Bye. I hate you.
Okay. Bye.
Who was that?
Well, I mean, it's not even fair to throw somebody's name. Chelsea Hartwell. Thanks, Chelsea.
That was great. Like she was on it. Like I felt like she was getting in the car.
She was emotional.
That was hilarious.
Yes.
Oh my, I need Chelsea's phone number.
At least she
answers when call.
Okay. Are you ready for your next one? You're going to have to switch over.
Oh, yep. That was great. And the fact that you didn't laugh or smile.
I know. And I felt her voice change too.
Mm-hmm. It did.
Oh,
you're in McCook?
Yeah.
I'm coming.
Yeah, I know.
Good job, Chelsea.
See, these people don't know what's happening.
This is freaking hilarious.
This is good. Okay. Ready?
I'm so nervous.
Oh, gosh, that one's good too. Okay. Oh.
Don't give me anything like deep.
No.
This
isn't deep.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay.
I'm so nervous.
You are catering a party.
Okay.
Your friend's birthday. The caterer calls to let you know she has the wrong date. Mm-hmm. You need someone who can make 200 cupcakes, a birthday cake, and 5 different appetizers.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who do you call?
She doesn't answer. My heart is going to be just broken.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, here we go.
Hello.
Alexa.
What's up?
What are you doing?
Nothing at the moment.
Okay, I have a really, really big favor to ask of you, and I'm more than happy to help you.
Okay.
Okay, with the baby. I can watch the baby. So I was supposed to be doing this huge freaking party on Sunday. I know we have games tomorrow, and I'm supposed to be bringing like 200 cupcakes, a birthday cake, and some appetizers. Help a sister out. I will help watch the baby. I can mix batter.
I don't know if I can do that.
Oh, Alexa.
By Sunday.
We can do it Saturday after the games. I love you.
I don't know. don't know if I can clip that.
Sorry, well, we're live on our podcast right now.
Her heart is breaking into pieces. In this very moment, she's devastated by your rejection.
Alexa!
When did you have your baby?
Like 2 weeks ago.
I'd say no to.
I would still call her. I would still call her.
She called you.
Yeah. Oh, I told her I'd help the baby.
Like the last time I saw you, you still had a bun in the oven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you tell her to go to Walmart and pick up some prepackaged cupcakes and she'll be fine.
Alexa, you just embarrassed me on public, nationally known podcast. Lord have mercy.
No, you know who should be embarrassed? Her. She should not be calling somebody who's 2 weeks post baby.
She's a superwoman.
She is.
She had that baby in like 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Well,
okay. I'll see you tomorrow.
Hi. I'm sorry.
Will I see you tomorrow?
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow.
All right. See ya.
You should warn me of things like this. What if I just said the whole
thing? That's gotta be real.
Yeah, it's like, yeah. No. This is real life situations we're trying to do.
Oh, here we go.
Okay. Next. See ya.
All right. Bye.
Don't look at me like that.
Oh, I'm not. I mean,
don't look
she
at me
did
like
just
that.
Have a baby in
she
2 weeks.
That's, yeah, I know, but she could have done it.
Well,
she could have done it.
I wouldn't have. I would have been like H to the no.
Did you send me this? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Mm-mm-mm. Gosh, this is either like building friendships or breaking them. This is just one of those things. This is yowzes.
Okay. Oh, we'll do this one. You're driving down a slick and muddy road.
Y'all flashbacks.
Yeah. That runs down the side of a mountain. Okay. Oh. You lose control and slide off the road, not to like teetering off the ledge, but it's pretty close.
Okay.
And you can't get out.
Okay.
Because if you get out, then the car's going to fall. Okay. So maybe it is teetering.
Okay.
Who do you call to rescue you?
Well, I know Jake won't answer. Or if he answers, he's not going to come get me.
Mm-hmm. So see, that's like.
I better go to a number two.
Okay.
Here we go. Or three. This is probably actually number six. So we'll try this one.
Are you afraid of people not answering? Because this is my point of life right now.
Oh, well, sorry.
And failure.
I'm not very. Okay. Alexa.
Hello?
Are you on lunch?
Yeah.
Jake is not answering and I am stuck. Like, I got stuck again.
You're stuck?
Yes, in the mud. Bad.
Okay.
Can you come get me? If I walk to the highway?
Yeah, I can come. I need to find someone to cover lunch.
Okay, awesome. You're amazing.
But I'll come.
Guess what?
All right.
Hey, wait, whoa.
What?
Hey, are you still there?
What?
I'm not stuck. Yes. We're doing a podcast. This is live. And thank you for answering and being willing to come get me. So.
All right. Well, yeah. At least now everybody on the podcast knows how awesome of a person I am.
Oh my, who is this person?
Mr. Zach Weezer.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, that's nice of
you
him.
You know what? I'm going to hang up with you and I'm actually going to call Jake to see if he would answer because I called you first. So thank you,
right,
Zach.
Okay, bye. What a nice human.
He is nice.
Is this your neighbor?
No, he's a teacher at St. Pat's.
Oh, wow, look at him. What is he? Like was he recess duty? He was going to find somebody to cover?
Yeah,
he was at recess. Now he was working.
Who wouldn't want to leave? Now we're going to find the real test.
Yeah. This would be how my phone calls.
What are you doing, Wiener?
I'm stuck.
What? You are not?
Yes, I am, and I'm running late for podcasts.
Bullshit.
Nope.
Lena, you can't be.
Yes, I can be.
Where'd you get stuck at?
Where they were they started maintaining the road in that really soft spot. And they
You're lying to me.
I'm not. I gotta be there by one. If I
take a picture and send it to me because I don't believe you.
Okay, if I walk to the highway, will you come get me?
No.
Okay, fine. Well, guess what? You were not my first call. Because I called somebody before you, and this is on the podcast, because I knew you wouldn't come get me. Thank you.
You are a turd. Okay, I hope you get stuck later. I'm not going to come get you out.
Okay, goodbye. Got to go.
Bye.
Well, that one's going to have to
that
be
was
censored.
Great. That
I
was
can't
great.
Believe he answered.
That, I know. Clay?
He actually texted me this morning because we had an extra kid at our house because we were supposed to have volleyball practice last night. And so I had to message the family. I was like, I'm not going out in this and I don't know what our roads are going to be like. So can we just keep your kid? And I'll take it. So then this morning he's like, you got to be careful going this way. And I was like, oh, because I have an extra kid and this is a townie.
Yeah.
And a townie's not used to having to be drove. You know what I mean?
Yeah, swirling around the dirt road.
Exactly.
Oh my goodness.
Well, thank you, Weezer, for coming to get me.
That was so good.
I bet I could have called like Joel Otterburn or Dan Hart. Well, a couple like those.
Yeah.
People. Okay.
Yeah.
Are we done? Or are we
I
done?
I don't know. I'm so nervous of how these go. I mean, I feel like I need one that's going to set me up for success, but.
Oh, yeah. You want to do that?
Okay, we can try.
All right. Let's see. Oh, you got to switch here.
And then I'm going to come up with a really good one for you.
Yeah, I feel so. I mean, I kind of feel bad for you. Oh, wait. Are you 0-2? Or are you kind of like, because one person answered, but they didn't help you?
Yeah.
You're 0-2.
I'm 0-2.
And I'm 2-2.
Yeah. So if this was a game, this is the competition thing I'm talking about.
YMCA volleyball flashback.
Gosh, okay. Something.
All right. Here we go. Ooh. Oh, those are yours. I got to get to mine. Oh. Stop it. It's game day and your car's in the shop and you have 30 minutes to get to your game. You split your pants as you are dropping off your car. You need to borrow some clothes and get a ride. Who do you call? I mean, if you don't call me, I'm sitting right here. I mean, I get we're not the same size, but you could borrow a belt.
I know you would not answer.
True story.
I know you would not answer. I'd call one or two people.
Mm. Well, I wish you well, friend. You know what? For our listeners, if somebody wants to have a trophy made for this, for the calling contest, as we like to call it, or emergency call contest, I feel like a trophy would be nice. I mean, or t-shirt. What do you want? Well, you won't be getting it, so I guess I shouldn't be asking you what you want. Good luck. She looks so serious right now, you guys. Aunt's
sad. I just don't know who to call. All right, it's like one or two. If this person doesn't answer, I'm going to call number two. You know what? I'm going to call both of them because they both should answer the phone. Here we go.
You zip it.
Hello?
Rachel, I have an issue.
Uh-oh.
I split my pants. And
you what?
I split my pants.
Okay, what do you mean?
Another pair of pants. And you know what's underneath my pants.
What is underneath?
Nothing. So I need another pair of pants, like real fast.
I'm in my car. Where do you want me to go? What do you need?
See,
oh,
Lena, I won.
Rachel, you saved the day. This is a call contest and she's not doing so well. You're the first one.
Did you really?
I didn't. No. Oh, see how sweet she is. There we go. I was like sweating.
She was sweating.
Where are you? Are you podcasting?
Yes.
Am I on your podcast?
Yes.
Oh, I'm honored. Oh. I was in the car, right? I'm like, okay, I'm going back to Walmart. I was about to go to my office. I was about to call the guy that I'm supposed to call at 1 and be like, hey, I got an emergency. I'll be right with you.
You are a winner.
So now I feel like I should get a trophy.
Okay.
The last two scenarios Lena's given me, they don't answer or they don't help me.
Nope.
Who didn't answer?
My brother.
Yep.
Yeah.
Garbage.
And then my other friend was like, yeah, you're on your own, sister.
Yep. Can't help you.
Yep. What?
I did ask her to make 200 cupcakes, even though she just had a baby.
Two weeks ago. I mean,
whatever.
Yeah. Hello.
Yeah.
I'd say no, even not having a baby 2 weeks ago. Sorry. Love you, Rachel.
Yeah, thanks, Rachel.
Love you, Lena.
All right. Bye. See you later. Bye.
Bye.
Is this going to be our last one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, wait, you got to switch. Yeah.
Yep. Okay. I need a good one for you. I just feel like I have, I feel like I need something better.
I mean, if you need to steal from my list, you can. It's fine. Okay. Great.
I like number one.
What's number one?
You're renewing your vows and wanting to have someone officiate your service.
Oh.
Who do you call?
I know I can call this person because they just did a wedding. I'm calling them. Here we go. Which is weird is because this is kind of from the same family.
Mm-hmm. Were we just in a text message with these people?
No. Oh, yeah. That'd be the other one I'd call.
We'll call him just for fun.
Okay.
Hello.
Hey, Dan, I have a quick question.
I hope you're not in jail.
No, I'm not. Dang it. This isn't going to work. Well, okay, it is going to work. Jake and I are going to renew our vows, and I know you just officiated a wedding. Would you do us the honor?
Well, how many people is it going to be in front of?
Don't, Dana doesn't.
Because that was a tough one.
12.
12.
Yeah.
Well, and if they're just your family and friends, sure.
Okay. Thanks. Thanks, Dan.
Yeah.
This is our, Dan, you're on our podcast. This is our calling episode. And,
what if you, what if she would have said 70? Would you have said no?
I love you too, sweetie. I would definitely officiate your wedding. I got in trouble because I kept saying I was marrying my brother-in-law, and that came out really awkward.
Oh. Yeah. That,
but I officiated. So I would officiate yours.
Aw, thanks.
I want to be part of this Hartwell family.
Well, just so you know, we're doing scenarios, and Cobes and I are calling people, and she's not faring so well, but I have done really well. And we didn't even tell people ahead of time we were calling them. So thank you so much for being there for me and Jake.
Absolutely.
All right. Have a good day, sir. Thank you.
You bet. See you. Bye. Bye.
What funny question could we ask?
Do you need me to call somebody else since I talked to his wife?
No, I feel like we should call Kyle, though, and ask him a funny question.
Okay. Deal.
I just don't know what that question would be.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I can't come anything. I can't come up. What? I can't come up with anything off the cuff.
No. No. Next time.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Next time.
We'll next time.
Up. We'll put our minds together and we'll come up. Some, well, you know, I want the listeners to know, in case they're just now jumping in and they only heard like the last two calls, you know, like maybe they like started and then like it was playing in the background and they weren't paying attention. I mean, and I'm not super competitive, but I do feel like we need to announce a winner in this situation.
I don't even know what you're talking about
right
now.
Well, I feel like there's, do you want to do like a drum roll or a congratulations or?
I don't feel like at the very beginning when we started this, we should have like set clear rules. Okay. Like, okay, let's see who wins. But we didn't do that. It was just more or less like, let's do this for fun.
Oh, so now we're playing for fun. But when we play volleyball at the Y,
that's different. It's just completely different.
Okay, yeah. Well,
I mean, see, we could arm wrestle or Indian leg wrestle after this.
Here's the deal. Okay. I want to be a winner in the game of life, not just volleyball. So I feel like this is when it really matters. Like, you know, okay. All right. Good times.
All right. You did okay. Really you did okay. You know what? You just, you have some good people.
Yeah.
You have some good people.
Yeah. That's, you know what? And if anything, that's what it should be about.
It's exactly right.
When we're talking about, it doesn't matter if you win, unless it's this, then it's about who you surround yourself with. Yeah.
Yeah. And you clearly, I want to be a part of this Hartwell group.
Well,
I hope their circle is a horseshoe and I am allowed into it.
Nope, we're cutting it off right now because when I need them, you're going to already be on the phone and then I'm going to be out. But I'm sure they would beep over.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. That was nice of them. That was nice. Yeah. You're just going to officiate your wedding. They'll pick you up.
Yeah.
That first one with Chelsea.
That was good. Oh, yeah.
Her voice was hilarious. Yeah.
So, yeah.
In McCook.
In McCook.
She didn't even ask, like, what for?
No. And
she was just coming.
Yeah.
You could have killed somebody.
Well, she probably figured that's what had happened.
And she was coming to get you.
Yeah. Try that. Oh, Jake and Lena are painting again. And Jake's. No one.
Oh, yeah.
That situation.
Yeah.
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 Come on now.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm glad we're back.
Yeah, I'm glad we're back too. This was fun.
This was fun.
I'm glad you got to see me.
I am too.
I'm glad you didn't scare me when I walked in.
Me too.
Everyone, thank you for like just
sticking
with us. Sorry, and
we
listening
had a little hiccup.
Yeah.
You know, life got crazy.
Yikes.
Yeah.
And you know, we need to take votes also. Uh-huh. Like, I think we should have a Christmas show.
For like a hee hee ha ha show?
Yeah, like a comedy show.
Okay. Let's do it.
Yeah. Like, I mean, I want to see some people.
I think our date for Valentine's Day is already confirmed.
Yes, it is. Yeah. I heard that.
Yeah, yeah.
I heard that.
Because I just got asked about like menu stuff the other day. So we know we're doing that.
Yeah.
We'll put on Facebook because we're going to hire a new manager.
Yep.
To do some of our
somebody
stuff.
Somebody that actually shows up and does the work.
Or the co-host could step up and do a little bit more.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say, you're going to do such a good job. Thank you.
Agreeing with what you said.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
First time. Yep. Let's do. And we're going to do our Gigograms.
Mm-hmm. Those are coming up.
Yes, they are.
And big things.
Yes.
Big
and
things.
Our birthday grams too. We're doing birthday and Gigograms.
And be ready for next week. Big guest.
He's
big
gonna be
guest
good.
Coming on. And I've seen him smile, so I think he'll be funny.
What?
He does. He does smile.
He does?
Yep. He has teeth.
Oh my gosh. That's incredible.
I know.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, wait. Oh, who are you thankful for?
Who am I thankful for? Well, I should say Rachel for answering the phone, but I think I've already said Rachel before.
Yeah.
But always thankful for Rachel. Mm-hmm. I am thankful for, who am I thankful for? I'm going to say all the male basketball, all the male coaches that I work with at the college, they are just all very, very supportive.
Oh, nice.
And they're just great. And they always can, you can always bounce ideas off of them. I'm going to say like Coach Brandel, Coach Pritchett,
right,
and even their assistants. They've all been super great to work with. I think I've said JO before, but like,
sure,
when like they just get it.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to say them, and they also, they're just good people.
That's very good.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say there's a teacher at St. Pat's. We're just right across the hall from each other, Mrs. Reisenhoover. And she's always like she leaves a lot. She lives close. So she goes home and she's like, show me grab a tea or grab anything when I'm going out. Like, oh, I'll get you a tea. And I just think that's so nice.
Yes.
Like that's just such, I mean, if she's making a stop, it's a big thing, but at the same time, it's just such a little thing, but it's so big to me, mm-hmm. you know, that she thinks about me when she's leaving, she's willing to, you know, make that stop. Mm-hmm. And it's just really nice.
Yeah.
Super nice.
And just, yeah, that small check-in.
Yeah.
And she means it.
Yes.
Yeah. I love that.
That's really good.
I love that.
And we already kind of talked about what we're reading and potting and
yeah, and all those
watching.
Things.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good times.
Mm-hmm.
This was fun.
This was so fun. I'm glad.
Glad we're back.
Glad we're back.
Okay.
All right. Thanks everybody for listening to another episode of Coaching Caffeine Comedy. I'm your host, Hayley Kobza.
And I'm Lena.
This is fitting for our close.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking.